He beat him like the match before this to be able to get here. Zamba just lost to Vivi, so you know that's why he's here. So let's see how this match pans out. Gozalina versus Goth. Jago is going to be a little bit out of play.
It's interesting. DeBuzz, I remember before the bracket started, was like, do you want to practice Zamba? And he was like, nah. Now it might come back to bite him. If I feel like DeBuzz Rosalina has historically done really well versus Zamba.
But look at that jump lead. Zamba followed him. I'm so surprised that DeBuzz did not choose to press a button in that instance. No forwarder, no neutraler, nothing. Just jumped back in with him.
Yeah, I feel like Zamba is that type of player who has a like mentality when they like go to losers, like they don't want to give up. They like kind of they almost get like angry. They like play better. So we're seeing Zamba on Demon Time right now, trying to beat DeBuzz.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I feel like right here DeBuzz's main goal is avoid this gyro.
Tries to go for the up early, but the gyro actually coming in so clutch that time around, just keeping Zamba so safe.
You should have listened to me.
Should have listened.
Should have listened.
Gotta tap in. Tap in.
And right there, the Nair is so strong when it comes to landing on the shield like that, because not only can you cross up which side of Zamba you're on, it's a multi-hit too. Mm-hmm. It's really tough. Like, that grab was so, like, free for DeBuzz right there.
I like how Zamba's also, like, baiting out, like, some of these dumbies from DeBuzz, because in positions where Zamba would typically almost always go for Laser Jago, he's just choosing not to. He's choosing not to, and then he's using that as an opportunity just to inch a little bit closer to the stage. What a spot dodge. I'm surprised DeBuzz, like, didn't opt to an option sooner.
Yeah, and that's so smart, because as long as, like, you're not in Rosa's burst range, which isn't that big, you know, Rosa doesn't have, like, an option that can super quickly, like, get you away from a far away, you don't have to throw out that gyro, you know? Yep. Like, you can wait for Rosa to do something, but I mean, landing has been a nightmare for Zamba, and he looks upset, leaning back on his chair, shaking his head. It's just so tough to land against Rosa, I feel like.
It's
feel
so
like
tough to land against DeBuzz.
Yeah, DeBuzz has such a read on Rob.
He's been doing this for so long. He knows how to shark you with Rosa. He knows how to follow you. He knows how to find that up smash. Up smash is going to be one of the biggest saving graces of Rosa. You know, such a big and important tool to be able to master. Tries to go for that other up here, and I like that bit of a fade back. It doesn't matter if that up here didn't connect. DeBuzz just try to keep himself safe.
And right there, Zamba, when after the kill side bead, I think he meant to pick up gyro, and now he didn't have time to pick up gyro. So now he's starting the stock, actually giving the gyro to DeBuzz. That was pretty unfortunate. Look at it.
I like that. That was pretty smart from Zamba. He tried to like bait out the first like down B so that he can then laser, but then he lasered like a little bit too soon. I believe the thought process was so.
The window's so tight.
You got to delay it just a little bit more so that it doesn't also get like sucked in.
And yeah, and DeBuzz is just comfortable matching it, you know. Because it's not like Zamba can hit him with a physical move from that far, so there's really very little reason not to. Good spot dodge.
Zamba's like trying to use those absorbs to his advantage, because it's like, okay, while I'm hitting this, I can fade in. What an up smash. Wow.
Yeah, that was like the fact that Rosa could dare and drift back that far to the right before landing and still be in range two up smash.
Let's see it.
Yeah, that was really strong.
Gets the jab. And then down air.
Yeah, and is able to down air while Zamba's moving forward and go
look
back.
Look at how far away that actually also
hit. That range.
Hit. That range on this. What are you hitting with? The crown? I guess so.
Yeah, it's definitely like shows such a mastery of Rosa from DeBuzz right there. You know, I feel like your average Rosa, which doesn't really exist, would not do that.
His decision-making, too, like when he's going for the dash attack, when he's going for the up smash instead, is so, so smart. Landing against DeBuzz is maybe one of the most uncomfortable places in the game, and Zamba is just struggling.
And this is number one and number two in New York fighting right now for fifth at Zeno, just to amplify that again. Like, this is, I feel like Zamba especially really doesn't want to go out at fifth, you know?
Nobody does. Who wants to?
Who wants to, yeah. I feel like he definitely like takes it to heart when he gets out of fifth. Like, it upsets him. He wants to keep being dominant in New York. So this means a lot to him.
Also, this says like a lot. Like, this is DeBuzz. Getting like competing for fifth at the local as well, you know? But wow, what a jump call out. Not even on Talon City, he's not going to kill. Rob just being heavy enough. That first, like bit of burner away from Gozalina was so smart. Zamba spacing was immaculate, but the Buzz was still able to find a kill.
Yeah, that was so good. And, like, this ledge trapping right here, I feel like the Buzz is just such, like, a knowledge of Rob. Really, is what this has come down to. And I think this is kind of how Zomba lost to DB2, is he keeps doing, like, what you expect a Rob to do. He's not, like, doing something that's super out of left field. And I think that's why it's just been really tough for him to get, like, a good lead going or, like, a really good...
Why did that side B send a Buzz like that?
I don't know. That
it should have... I feel like Zomba's side B to the right.
No, I believe he was facing towards the stage.
Oh, no. But, you know, either way, Thanos stock. Keeping it pretty even. He's taking a sweet old time landing this time, not like trying to mess with the Buzz, because last time he tried to, he took 80% for it. So just being as patient as possible.
And you know, I'm not one to want to give credit to a Rob for nairing, but that nair was beautifully spaced by Zomba. You gotta try where credit's due. He was exactly above the Buzz to where the like bottom initial hitbox of the bottom hitbox of the nair would be at max range, and actually managed to like outspace that up smash. Really clean stuff. And I feel like he needs that. This is actually like looking pretty even. You know, I could totally see Zomba gain some momentum
has
going.
Cleaned up and changed up a lot of his landings, the way that he's timing himself, the way that he's stalling, and the way that he started throwing in backhands and hitting the Buzz's shield so much safely than he was before. But he was already hand in the sky. He was already like, what the hell just happened?
Yeah, that was so tricky. You know, the Buzz let that Luma stay still and then walk to mid stage. And I feel like Zomba's eyes were peeled on Rosa herself. Not able to deal with that.
Why did he double jump side B back onto the stage?
Yeah, he definitely seems like a bit off with his execution right now.
If possible, I want to see a replay on that side B. I really don't know why. I've never seen like Rob move like that with side B. No.
Oh. And this right here, DeBuzz like is so comfortable right now to shield pressure. I feel like DeBuzz can always drift away from up smash range, so there's nothing threatening his life. And Zomba seems very
Zomba's tilted, clearly
upset.
I mean, this feels like a little bit over, like mentally. But that was such a good way to get back on. Double jump, neutral air dodge is such a smash foil thing to do. I feel like everybody has been implementing it just a little bit more. It was the exact option he needed, but.
Zomba a lucky break falling out of Rose's fair right there. That would have been it. We saw him gamer lean when he took that stock. You know, what? One last ditch effort. Close this out. And
he's
this is
how
you so start.
Meticulously.
You know, we've seen Zomba actually make some pretty crazy comebacks against Tilde, particularly at the Connecticut regional that happened. I forget the name. He made a really good comeback. Hold the line. Yeah, he made a really amazing comeback in Grands when he was on game point. See if he can pull it off again.
He wants to get a Z-catch on the Gyro. Was not able to do so. Just dashing back and forth in shield. That was an amazing down smash. Tries to get Luma out of there. Not enough to get her out of commission. The back throw can't do it, but it's stage control. And now Zomba needs a weight just to be able to land. Held on to his double jump. Amazing.
Yeah, that was such a good landing right there. And now Luma off the table. This is scary, but...
Again, those double jump neutral air dodges.
And
it's
now,
constantly saving Zomba.
No jump onto Buzz. I'm not sure if I feel like that was a down air. Much more.
Oh, that back end.
No.
That second back end is a bit of a mistake.
And that's frustrating. I feel like he had the Buzz jump was having to recover low and went for that side B. I feel like that was either a side B facing to the right or a down air was the option Zomba should have gone for right there.
I don't know why it sent like that.
Yeah, but he was facing towards the left of the stage, and so the Buzz had a very easy like tech to react to. That's so tragic. Zomba cannot be happy about that. I think
there is a lot to be noted about how well Zomba was playing.
Yeah.
The way that he was implementing double jump neutral air dodge to get back against those Rosaline and Luma setups, I feel like is something to really take home.
Yeah.
I feel like that was such a good exemplification. I have not seen that many people get off ledge against the Buzz at all, period. It is one of the most difficult things.
I mean, yeah, he's showing why he's number two in New York, like almost making that comeback right there. Because he was obviously like tilted that mm-hmm. set, managed to get the Buzz to last stock, kind of breathe in, and was like, I still can do this. I still, yeah. I've been watching the Buzz this whole set. I know what options he's going to go for. Honestly had it. He had that game and kind of messed up in that edge guard. That's a bummer. The Buzz, though, gonna be moving on. Gonna be fighting Numbers.
Oh, no. Numbers took it over Zane. Tragedy. Good stuff to numbers. Just saying, you know what?